students, welcome to Maths online class. Today we are going to see the second chapter, measurement. Students, in class 6 we studied about area and perimeter of rectangle, square and right angle triangle. Let us recall the concept of perimeter and area of square, rectangle and right angle triangle. Area: the amount of space inside the boundary of a two-dimensional shape. Perimeter is the distance around the outside the dimensional shape. That means add up the length of the sides. Square: perimeter of a square is equal to 4 into a units. Here a means one side of a square. Then area of a square equal to a into a square units. Next, rectangle. Perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into l plus b units. Area of a rectangle equal to l into b square units, where l and b are the length and breadth of the rectangle. Right angle triangle. Area of the right angle triangle equal to half into b into h square units. Here b is the base and h is the height of the triangle. Students, now we are going to learn about some more four-sided shapes, namely parallelogram, rhombus and trapezium. First one is parallelogram. This shape is like a parallelogram. A, B, C, D, four-sided closed shape. Then AB is the base of the shape and DE is the height of the shape. See, the definition of the parallelogram is a four-sided closed shape in which opposite sides are equal and parallel. AB is equal to CD and also AB is parallel to CD. Then AD is parallel to BC. See, what is the difference between parallelogram and rectangle? Parallelogram means here A is acute angle and B is an obtuse angle. But in a rectangle, the adjacent sides make exactly 90 degree. That is the difference between parallelogram and rectangle. Now, what is the formula to find out area of parallelogram? That is enough to multiply the length of base and height. So area of the parallelogram equal to base into height square units. We can write BH square units. Here B means base and H means height. Then to find perimeter of the parallelogram, we have to add sum of the length of four sides. So area of the parallelogram formula BH square units and perimeter of the parallelogram sum of the length of four sides. Next, rhombus. The definition is in a parallelogram, if all the sides are equal, then it is called a rhombus. See the shape A, B, C, D. All the sides are equal in a rhombus and opposite sides are parallel. AB is parallel to BC and CD is parallel to AB. Already we know what is the meaning of parallel. Parallel means the two sides never meet each other at any point. Then AC is one diagonal and BD is another diagonal. These two diagonals intersect at the point O, then the angle is equal to how much degree? 90 degree, that means right angle. Okay, next we are going to see the properties of rhombus. First property, all the sides are equal, opposite sides are parallel, diagonals divide the rhombus into four right angle triangles of equal area, then the diagonals bisect each other at right angles. These are the properties of a rhombus. Next, what is the formula to find out area of the rhombus? Area of the rhombus equal to half into d1 into d2 square units. Here D1 and D2 are the diagonals of the rhombus. See, the derivation of the formula is given in your book. Just you go through that. Trapezium. See this definition. A parallelogram with one pair of non-parallel sides is known as a trapezium. Here, one pair of parallel sides, AB and CD are parallel sides, but BC and AD are not parallel. So here, that is given, one pair of non-parallel sides is known as a trapezium. Then, the distance between the parallel side is the height of the trapezium. The distance between parallel side is the height of the trapezium. And one more definition is given, that is, what is the meaning of isosceles trapezium? If the non-parallel sides of a trapezium are equal, then it is known as an isosceles trapezium. To find area of the trapezium, that is equal to half into h into a plus b square units. Here h means the distance between the parallel sides, and a and b are the length of the parallel sides. Then to find the perimeter of the trapezium, equal to sum of the length of all the four sides. Okay students, in this video we learned about the formulas of area and perimeter of the shapes parallelogram, rhombus and trapezium. Using these formulas we are going to do the sums. So revise all the formulas. Okay dear students, today's session over. With another video we will meet again. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.